Ecamm fam, what's good y'all? This is Marshall Fox and today I'm going to show you a couple simple techniques that you can use to take your live stream game to the next level using overlays in Canva. So if you don't know me for what I do outside of Ecamm, I'm actually a graphic designer and I put together a whole video explaining how to make overlays using the tools that I use, and it was about 45 minutes long. So I went back to the drawing board, I learned Canva a bit so I can show you the easiest way possible to create your overlays. The best thing is, it's free. You don't even need the paid version. All right, let's get into it. All right, so go ahead and fire up Canva and click this purple create a design button at the top right. And what I recommend is clicking this custom size button and doing 3840 by 2160 since this is 4K. It's not necessary, but once we get to the second part of this video, it'll make cutting out the sections that we need a lot easier. And you're presented with a bunch of different options to start from on the left-hand side. You can go down to background and they have different gradients, patterns, landscapes, textures, etc. Let's choose this one. Go over to elements and I want to create the cutouts that will be seen in Ecamm. So I'll go to see all and I like this one right here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make an overlay for, let's say, three people. So what I'll do quickly is just eyeball it and size these for three people. So I'll do Command D to duplicate it and Command D again to duplicate it. So it looks like I have a bit more room. So I'll do it like this. I'm just eyeballing it. So I'll do Command D again at this size and Command D again one more time. So now it's like they could stand to be a little smaller, but this is fine. So snap to the middle, snap to the side. But what I want to do is I will make each of these white. Okay, so now we have the three cutouts. So the reason I have more space at the bottom is because you may want to have comments. Let's say you're live streaming with these three people and you want to leave room for the comments to pop up. So that's why I left more room at the bottom. Or maybe you want to have their names at the bottom, like your name and your two guest names, and you can add a card for that. So you could actually have it over top of the cutout if you want it. But in this situation, let's put it down here and let's make it like this color right here. And I'll do Command D. Command D to duplicate. So now and Ecamm will write their names, the guest names here. Or you could do it in advance if you wanted to. So now what I'll do is I'll do download as is. Okay, and we'll just do a three person overlay. So this is where the magic happens. It's a bit of a workaround, but it works. So I'll open this up in preview. So I'll hit this button right here, show markup toolbar. Then I'll come over here on the left hand side and click instant alpha. So now I'll just click the white area until it highlights red and let it go. And now I'll click delete. So I'll do the same for this one. Delete, same for this one. Oops, selected too much. So if you select too much like this, then the whole thing will be selected, and then if you hit delete, the whole thing will be deleted. So you don't want that. So I do Command Z. So I just want the white section to be selected. Okay, I gotta do it over again. There we go. So it may take you a couple tries. Hit delete. So now they're cut out. So we save it. We're good to go. So I'm just gonna add a page here. Come over to the left hand side, click photos. Click uploads, upload media, device, colorful gradients, JPEG, and let's pick one at random here. Now bring it over. Let's do a circle. Okay, so I'll click elements. I like this one, so I'll move it over here. Let's say I'm doing a screen share, so I want a circle for my photo and then a square for screen share. So I'll add a square here, resize it for screen share. Okay, so It's important. We want as much contrast as possible. So if this was a light background, then I would want to use like a black circle, because it would make it easy for whatever machine learning that selects this once we're in preview to differentiate between the background and the foreground. So, but in this case, it's a darker background. So I'll make these white again. And you can change the color of this drop shadow as well. So let's do that. Boom. That's cool. So let's move this over. And now do download. So I'll just do the second page this time. So now I'll open this up in preview. Click the markup button. Top right, and then instant alpha, same process, highlights, delete, highlight, delete. So now we have two cutouts. So now let's jump over into Ecamm and show you how to add these. All right, so I just fired up Ecamm. Let's go ahead and add these overlays in. Okay, so let's do the first one, the three person overlay. So this is for you if you use interview mode, okay, which is available for pro members. So I just dragged it onto the screen, but what I'm actually going to do is add in a guest. Let's add in two guests, one guest, two guests. So there I am, right? Boom. So I'm going to go ahead and save this as a scene, default scene. So let's just save it and like rename it. Okay. So let's do three person scene. So let's create a new empty scene for the next one. But what I'm going to do in this case is I'm going to go to source blank. Okay, so it's going to go black on me, but I'll go ahead and add in the overlay now. Boom. So now I'll come down here and do new camera overlay. So I'll just drag myself here and I'll hit this pencil. Change the aspect ratio to round. I'll resize it, but the key is I want to put this underneath this overlay. So I'll just drag this camera overlay behind or underneath of this overlay too, right here in the overlays panel on the right hand side. So now I'm underneath. So here I want to do a screen share. So you can do this one of two ways. All right, so the first way would be to do a screen share and resize and reposition the window of what you're trying to share. Let's say I'm trying to share something online, I would have to reposition it. But depending on how big your screen is, and if you're running your entire presentation and live stream from one monitor, this may not be feasible. So another way would be to use Ndi Tools. So shout out to Doc Rock. I started using this after he recommended it. So let's go to Ndi Tools. It's ndi.tv. We're on Mac, so we would click Ndi Tools, go to download Ndi Tools for Mac. So put your information in, then you want to install the one that says Ndi Scan Converter. This is the one you want to install. So once it's installed, you open it up, you want to go to file and then select which application you would like to share. So once you do that, it'll be shown as a source inside of Ecamm. So if I want the Safari window as a source, so I will make sure that this source is set to blank. Source blank. I have my camera overlay here and I'm basically going to add another camera overlay, but I have to make sure that it's selected. Safari is selected. And NDI. Now I'll come here, go to overlays, new camera overlay. So I'm going to change it to Marshall's iMac scan converter. Yours will be named accordingly. And aspect, I'll do custom just so I can resize it exactly how I want it. So then I got to make sure that I put the layer below the overlay, right? Then I can resize this a bit as well. Actually, I can actually move this out of the way and do it on another screen to make sure it fits perfectly. And there it is. So now I can do what I gotta do. and share this. And of course, you can have tons of different overlays. I just gave you a brief overview of a couple different styles that you could do. So the possibilities are truly endless. If you experiment, use different shapes, use different backgrounds, just play around with it a bit. Don't get overwhelmed. You'll have a lot of fun and you'll really help to upgrade your live stream game using Ecamm. If you like Marshall, all that was cool and all, but ain't nobody got time for that. I got you. I just dropped an overlay pack that's available to pick up right now at the link in the description. But let me know what you thought of this video. If you found it helpful, please drop a comment and don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you can be notified when more videos drop. Peace. And don't forget.